For coming out today, we would like to welcome our elected officials, our community partners, school personnel, and other advocates for children. Your being here is a wonderful symbolic representation of how you feel about the children in Alamance County. So we want to welcome you today. The next voice you will hear will be Toomey from East Lawn Elementary.
Today we gather together to kick off April's Child Abuse Prevention Month. Child abuse and neglect occurs when parents or caregivers are stressed, lack support, and lack understanding of child development and parenting. Abuse and neglect hurts children in many ways. Young children are at special risk. They may not grow properly, develop learning problems, feel bad about themselves, or not trust other people. Sometimes they die. Children often believe abuse or neglect is their fault. They may think they did something wrong and deserve what happened. It is up to adults who care to protect them. We bring awareness to the need for prevention of child abuse and neglect by wearing blue ribbons, planting pinwheels, or ringing of the bells. When families have the help and assistance they need to put protective factors in place, children can be happy, healthy, and successful. It is important for families to know there is help available and resources to get the support they need. Take the time this month to engage in activities like wearing blue, ringing bells, planting pinwheel gardens, and wearing blue ribbons to bring awareness to this important cause.
Good afternoon, I'm Lynette Wellens with Alamance County DSS. We're grateful for the opportunity to be here today to bring awareness along with our community partners to the issues that impact our most vulnerable citizens. Today we'll be giving you some local Alamance County data and reading the Starfish story, which is enclosed in your program. Amanda Keys and Rhonda Cheney will be our staff relaying that to you today.
The following is data from Alamance County fiscal year July 2017 to June of 2018. The Alamance County Department of Social Services received 2,265 reports of alleged child abuse, neglect, and dependency, an increase of 122 reports from the previous fiscal year. Of those 2,265 reports, 1,249 reports met the statutory criteria to assess for concerns of abuse, neglect, or dependency involving 2,689 children. Of those reports, 191 children were found to have been abused, neglected, or dependent, and 157 were found to be in need of further child protective services, giving a total of 347 children who received post-assessment investigative services through in-home services or foster care. 1,079 children were recommended to receive services outside of child welfare's involvement to include services like mental health, medical care, or remedial care, to name a few. Over the last year, the Alamance County Department of Social Services has had on average 90 children in foster care. While the amount of children entering foster care continues to be on the rise, both statewide and nationwide, the Alamance County Department of Social Services works diligently in determining permanent outcomes for children outside of foster care and has established this for 54 children over the last fiscal year with support and assistance from many of our valuable partners. The Alamance County Department of Social Services is proud to be a part of a community that takes such a collaborative effort to protect children at risk and prevent them from future harm. It is because of these partnerships that we have collectively been able to make positive, life-altering differences in the lives of many children.
I will be reading to you the Starfish story. One day, a man was walking along the beach when he noticed a boy hurriedly picking up and gently throwing things into the ocean. Approaching the boy, he asked, "Young man, what are you doing?" The boy replied, "Throwing starfish back into the ocean." the surface up and the tide is going out. If I don't throw them back, they'll die. The man laughed to himself and said, don't you realize there are miles and miles of beach and hundreds of starfish? You can't make any difference. After listening politely, the boy bent down, picked up another starfish, and threw it into the surf. Then smiling at the man, he said, I made a difference with that one.
Kelly Stutz, founder of Connect for Faith and the Child Sexual Abuse Prevention Initiative. And thank you for being here. I think many of us during the winter, we had hope for spring and the sunshine and the blooming flowers. Just like that, we can have hope to protect our children. They deserve our best. It is up to us, the adults in the community, to protect our children. We make the difference. We prevent these crimes against children. We don't often like to call them that, but that's what they are. And so it's up to us as parents, as community members, as leaders, as teachers, as guardians. It's not just the organizations represented here. It's each one of us. And so I thank you for being here as leaders, because you're here showing your support for our children. So thank you so much. It is my honor to introduce some of our special guests and our community leaders today. They are going to read the proclamation declaring April as Child Abuse Prevention Month. So I'm going to introduce them all, and then they will take their turns reading. So thank you for your attention for them. From the Alamance County Sheriff's Department, we have Chief Deputy Cliff Parker, Alamance County Clerk of Court Meredith Edwards. We have Graham Chief of Police Jeffrey Pritchard, Alamance County District Attorney Sean Boone, Mayor of Graham Jerry Peterman, Alamance County Commissioner Chair Amy Gailey, North Carolina House Representative Dennis Riddell. Thank you for your attention.
Whereas child maltreatment is a community problem and finding solution depends on involvement among people throughout the community. Whereas child maltreatment occurs when parents find themselves in stressful situations without community resources unable to cope.
Whereas 139,529 children reported as abused and neglected in North Carolina and 82 children reported in Alamance County from July 2017 to June 2018, whereas 27 children were victims of child abuse homicide in North Carolina in 2016.
Whereas child abuse costs the country over $124 billion each year. Whereas the majority of child maltreatment cases stem from situations and conditions that are preventable in an engaged and supportive community. Whereas the effects of child maltreatment are felt by whole communities and need to be addressed by the entire community.
Whereas child maltreatment not only directly harms children, but also increases the likelihood of criminal behavior, substance abuse, health problems such as heart disease and obesity, and risky behaviors such as smoking.
Whereas all citizens should be involved in supporting families raising their children in safe, nurturing environments.
Whereas effective child maltreatment prevention programs succeed because of partnerships created among social service agencies, schools, faith communities, civic organizations, law enforcement agencies, and the business community.
Therefore, we, the community of Alamance County, do hereby proclaim April as Child Abuse Prevention Month in the state of North Carolina and Alamance County. And we call upon all citizens, community agencies, faith groups, medical facilities, and businesses to increase their participation in our efforts to prevent child maltreatment and strengthen the communities in which we live. Amen.
Good afternoon. My name is Stacy Allred, and I'm with the Exchange Club's Family Center in Alamance, and we're a child abuse prevention center just a block away. Wanted to share these numbers one more time because of how profound they are. You've already heard them, let's hear them again. 139,529. The number of children that were reported as abused or neglected or both in the state of North Carolina for fiscal year 17-18. 2,582. The number of children reported right here in Alamance County during that same time. 27. The number of children victims of child abuse homicide in North Carolina in 2016. These numbers are high, they're way too high, and we're doing something about it already, but it's time that we do more. Now, we live in a time where we already have a whole lot of challenges. We've got the ice bucket challenge. We have the mannequin challenge. We've got the lip sync challenge. And we even have this new water bottle flip challenge thing. And I see people all the time participating in those challenges because they choose to, because they think it'd be fun, entertaining, and because they volunteer to. But what about the real life challenge of child abuse we're facing every day, right here, right now? Where's all the folks volunteering to jump in and put an end to it? Now, there's several of us right now that do this, but we need more. We need the community's help. We need their volunteerism. We need more people to be advocates for children, to be a voice for them. We need healthy role models in our community to step up and show our youth how to live healthy, how to live appropriately, and how to stop this cycle of abuse that keeps repeating itself over and over and over again. So I challenge you, the community, the volunteers, to participate in this challenge, to partner with us in reducing child abuse, to remain in denial that it's a problem or even refusing to do anything about it. Makes us just as complicit as the perpetrator. It almost makes us a co-perpetrator. We are all responsible for the protection of our children. We can protect children by supporting their self-esteem, fostering techniques of self-protection in our families for our actions, and speaking out when we see other kids getting abused. So let's work together. 140,000 is way too high. 2,600 is too high. 27 is too high. Even one is way too high. Let's work together to overcome this challenge. Now, the staff that works with the Family Center, raise your hand. All right? It's a very short number of folks. If you want to get involved, please see one of those folks that had their hands raised. Come find me after, and we'll put you in the ring, and we'll try to knock child abuse out. Thank you.
You a couple more ways to get involved. I'm Julie Budd with Crossroads, the Child Advocacy Center, and I have with me an invited guest from Raleigh. I'll let her introduce.
I'm Andrea Dalporto with Prevent Child Abuse North Carolina.
So one of the first things that you can do is when you do plant your pinwheel, please take a picture of it and share it on social media. You are also welcome to use this frame to put your family members, your friends, whatever you want to do as far as creating social media pictures so that Alamance County is serious about ending child abuse. And then the other thing, another exciting way you can really help is to be informed. And we're offering a movie at the Graham Cinema. It's free. It's today at 4:00. And we've done many of these showings across the state. And it's actually through the efforts of Prevent Child Abuse that we're able to bring the Resilience movie to you today. So I'll let Andrea share about the Resilience movie.
So how many of you have heard of the study about adverse childhood experiences? Many of you, awesome. And I just want to echo what everybody has already said. We are the hope. You all are the hope. We all are the hope, a collective hope for ending this in Alamance County. And I'm excited about the work that's already being done and the awareness that's being brought forth in the Resilience documentary. How many of you have seen this? Yes? Okay. So I'm going to challenge you, if you have not seen it, to make it a priority to come out at 4:00 today and watch this, and then really start thinking, what is the next step that you can make? Thank you. we are blessed today with a lot of great voices. And so in just one moment, we're going to hear from, and you may remember her from last year, Caroline Seekers from Eastern High School. And she's going to bless us with her voice and a real powerful solo. But before we do that, I ask that you join with me in a moment of silence. Out of respect for the children and the families that have suffered child abuse, as well as for those that we have lost.
Can we give another hand to Caroline? Now, before Graham Middle School performs for you in a second, let me say that nearly 70% of abuse and neglect cases that are reported by educational personnel, medical personnel, courts, and human services. About 30% were referred by relatives, non-relatives, parents, or care providers. Child victims only self-reported fewer than 1%. So children speaking up for themselves only accounted for 1%. Because of this, please allow me to explain the purpose of the bells. The Ring Out is an annual event to kick off National Child Abuse Prevention Month in April, and the ringing of the bells is symbolic of the calling of attention to child abuse and neglect, as well as reminding children that it's important to make as much noise as possible about any maltreatment that they might be experiencing. So let's all together raise our bells high, ring them just as loud as you can.
Good afternoon, I'm Valerie Chafin. I'm the District Administrator of the Guardian Ad Litem Program here in Alamance County. And this is a real uncomfortable position for me to have this many children behind me, because my job and my volunteers are to support and give the voice for children in court. But I want you to give one more show of appreciation to all the children that are sitting behind me now. And is that not a gorgeous sight of that many young people sitting on the steps of a courthouse? Show me another courthouse in North Carolina that's got this many children sitting in front of it. I don't think you're going to find any. So thank you guys very much. This many polite children sitting in front. So again, I'm with the Guardian Ad Litem program. Our program supplies volunteer community leaders, volunteers being the key word, to advocate for children like these that are in court due to abuse and neglect. We provide trained volunteers, and I'm going to say that word as many times as I can get out of my mouth in the few minutes before I bring on my special guest, because I want that to be the invitation that I bring to you today to be a volunteer for our organization. And if you'll go on www.volunteerforgal.org, we will love to have you as part of our training force. And without further ado, I'd like to introduce the Chief District Court Judge who presides over the children we bring into court, Chief Brad Allen.
Good afternoon to everyone. On behalf of myself, Judge Overby, Judge Messick, and Judge Brown, we want to thank everyone that is here today. This is a very important event. I want to salute and applaud all the GALs, all the Department of Social Services workers, the attorneys, even the attorneys that represent the parents, because it is a passion that they each have, and even the attorneys are trying to get the parents to work through their case plan, to do what they're supposed to do, so they can become, again, productive parents and productive citizens. All four of the judges in Alamance County, we rotate on a weekly basis and hear child abuse, child neglect, and child dependency cases. These cases are not easy. These cases are difficult. These cases will leave you stressed. It'll leave you where you're thinking about it at night when you go home. And yeah, I want to thank all the community members, because without the community members, where we live in a community, that the people truly do care about one another. I can't think of a better place to live than Alamance County. And when someone in the community observes someone having a child being abused or neglected, they do report it. And we end up hearing these cases every Wednesday almost. I think there's a couple Wednesdays we don't have court, but that's because of schedules and vacations or holidays. As a judge, we hear parents come into court making excuses all the time. They are making excuses for what they have done, why everyone is mistreating them, why everyone's picking on them. Then we hear other parents that understand that they need to do better. We hear about the children. Some children, occasionally, it's rare, the children don't want to go home. The majority of the children want to go back because that is their family, that is their environment. And then we also hear about other relatives and volunteers and friends that help to take in the children that have been traumatized, to try to make them to have a normal, somewhat life, in that even though the things that they have gone through, they're there and they're supportive. We also have foster parents, who I applaud every single one of you. If any of you are here, I thoroughly want to thank you for what you do for these children. After about 19 years here on the bench, I can tell you that the cases that I still remember are the ones in DSS court. I have a real good memory for most all my cases, but the ones in DSS court always are on the forefront. I will tell you that last week I had a large docket. There's two families that I've been dealing with for almost a year and over a year. And they have come together, both of these families, and I want to tell you they had a long case plan, they had a lot of things that they needed to do, and they have. And the children are being put back in the homes of where they were when they were abused, neglected, and dependent. And it's a very, very happy, rewarding moment for the court to be able to do that. Every week we hear about these cases, and the most important thing that all judges would all strive for, the DSS workers, the guardian ad litem, the parent attorneys, we're striving to have safety and some type of normalcy back in the lives of the children. We do this with the hope, and I say hope, that these children that have been abused and have been neglected will not grow up and become the type of parents that they were living in. We want them to be productive citizens. We want them to be loving parents and an asset to our community. Again, thank you all very much.
So what can you do? Going forward, you can go to a movie this afternoon at 4 o'clock and see the Resilience movie over here at the Graham Theater. You can wear blue for the foreseeable future. It looks good on most of us. You can tell your children and tell your grandchildren about events like these, so next year we have twice the capacity. But most importantly today, boom, you can plant pinwheels. And so in the crowd, there are several blue baskets. If you don't have a pinwheel in your hand, get one in your hand. And I'm going to show you how to plant them. There are 179 of ones that look like this because the Guardian Ad Litem Office last year advocated for 179 abused, neglected children in court, and a record number. And there are 27 of these with white bows on them, and they're to honor the memory of the 27 children that were lost in care in North Carolina last year. So there are 207 pinwheels around our grounds today, and we need them. We need them planted on the courthouse grounds. And if you look around to my left and right, and it's in the back of the courtroom too, you'll see chopsticks planted in the mulch areas around the trees, and that's where we want you to put them. Not in the grass, because that needs to get cut. We want them to stay up here the whole month. So we want you to plant, but I'm going to dismiss you just a few minutes to run and go plant them, because it's a beautiful sight. But then I want you to come back down here any night. Yeah, any night. But over the next month, find a parking place, bring a snack, and look up. And what you're going to see behind me is the most beautiful courthouse in North Carolina, because it's going to be bathed in this beautiful blue. It is the only courthouse I know of, and we've been doing this for 4 years now, that will be bathed in blue to bring awareness to child advocacy and child neglect and abuse in North Carolina to anybody that's coming through Graham at the crosswalk of this courthouse. And it is breathtaking. So definitely come down. I have to give them a shout out to Graham Maintenance, the county maintenance, for making sure this happens every year, because those guys rock. So without further ado, thank you again for all our partners on this venture. Thank you for showing up and showing your support, not only to the children behind me, but the children that aren't here today that we have to give their voices to and plant toys with. And have a great day.